One thing that people can do is to start looking at their own double standards about sexuality, sexual expression, sexual preference, sexual choice. That can happen. It'll make them act when there is a violation that happens in their neighborhoods.
Namaste. I come from Sangram, which is located in Sangli, India. It's a health and human rights NGO. It works to address social inequality and to promote justice among marginalized communities, discriminated against because they challenge the dominant norm of sexual expression, sex work, HIV status, gender, caste, and religious minority. Sangram focuses on building solidarity by using a right-centered approach to self-determination that organizes the voiceless to collectivize as a key strategy. We wanted to explore alternative visions of society that promoted the rights of people who have been pushed to the margins. This led us to formulate the Sangram Bill of Rights. People have the right to be approached with humility and respect. You know, I was trained as a social worker. And you know, social workers, we guide communities. That's our job. And so I was all ready to go and start working with this community and guide them. And can you imagine my surprise when the community resisted it totally and said, listen, you have no knowledge about sex work. You have no understanding of what it means to be a sex worker. What do you mean by saying you want to guide us? And whoa, I was like, I'm sorry. I agree. I know nothing. Can you please teach me? And that's what happened. That's how the first Bill of Rights came up. The middle class, upper caste woman in India has no clue how the common, poor sex workers live. But yes, we have the education and the privilege to believe that we can teach them anything, even about their own life and their own experiences. We learned that you can't do that. You have to let the community lead your programs. You have to go there and be humble, and you have to be respectful of the community to be able to get any kind of justice for the community. People have the right to reject harmful social norms. We work with rural women. We work with Muslim women. We work with women who are living on the margins of society, mainly because of domestic violence. When we wanted to do the International Women's Day, and we wanted to have a rally, they were up in arms. They said, we don't want the trans women, and we don't want the lesbian women among us, because the women are not good women. It's at that time that we decided that this has to change. If trans women are saying that they are women, then the women's rights movement will have to accept them and say that they are women, they have rights as women, and their rights will be honored. It's activists like us from the women's rights women movement who have to learn that these are harmful social norms that we have imbibed also as feminists and as part of the women's rights movement. This has to change. People have the right to stand up and change the balance of power. Sex workers have faced police brutality forever. This is a story of Anu Mokkal, who was pregnant, who was not soliciting, but the police inspector decided she was soliciting and beat her up. And when he was beating her up, she was pleading with him. I can't breathe. She was saying, I'm pregnant. Leave me alone. And he said, you're lying. And right enough, 3 days later, she lost her baby. We put up a big protest. We said, we are not going to take this lying down. All the collectives came together. LGBT, sex workers, everyone, the women's rights, everybody, Dalit rights, the religious minority rights, we all came together and said, this is something we are not going to stand. Of course, the police officer denied all responsibility, but the government, because of the collectivization, because of the protest, had to transfer him out of that area. People have the right not to be rescued by outsiders who neither understand nor respect them. You know, we have our own religious vigilantes, right? They're dying to rescue us. Unfortunately, people from the United States of America, the evangelical groups here. They targeted Sangram's work, and they came all the way to small Sangli, and they got the community raided. The raids were, you know, performed with thug-like brutality. Raids don't help anyone. My invitation is to the evangelicals and the religious vigilantes from India to come and sit with that community, work with them. We've been doing that. We've been able to root out minors and sex work. We've been able to root out exploitation of brothel owners. We've been able to root out violence. People have the right to exist how they want to exist. This photograph says a lot to me. This is a boy who wanted to dress up and come for one of our protests. And he wanted to come on his motorcycle. And he wanted to drive it on the streets of Meerut. That was his dream. To be able to do it in a safe space, not get heckled, not get physically assaulted, not get verbally assaulted. And we said, yes, if that's the dream you have, go ahead and do it, and we will support you. And what's not there in the photograph actually is a lot of big group of us walking beside him when he's driving this motorcycle in full drag, as you can see, totally enjoying himself, because we actually sincerely and really believe that people have the right to exist exactly how they want to exist. And we cannot take this away from them. No agency in this world can take this away from them. It is their right to livelihood, their right to life, their right to life to live without discrimination, without stigma. And who are we, mere mortals, to take that away from them? Thank you.